Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible say, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day.
Which is more important, Christmas or Easter? We know that the correct answer is Easter, but most people prefer Christmas. At Christmas, we visit our friends, we have parties, we give each other presents. Yes, of course it's true that Jesus died for us, and yes, of course it's true that death is a big thing for us human beings, and having someone die for us is a very big thing indeed. But still, death, although it is big, it happens to everyone. On the other hand, when you think that the infinite being, the power that made the galaxies, should be shut up in a human body, that is unique. That is incredible. It's unbelievable. Look how many people refuse to believe in it. The conversation between Mary and the angel Gabriel turned the power relationship between the infinite creator and the finite creature upside down. The fact that the infinite creator actually became a creature changes everything. Many people try to get around this by saying that Jesus was really God, but not really a man. Others say that he was a man, a human being, but not really God. The truth is that he was both God and man. So let's suppose for a moment that Jesus is either God himself or a spirit sent from God. Suppose he was something like the angel Raphael, who we read about in the book of Tobit in the Bible. Many of you will remember the story. The old man Tobit was blind. He sent his son Tobias to a different country to collect some money. And this character called Raphael accompanied Tobias and enabled him to get through some pretty sticky situations. But he got him home safely, and in the end, Raphael even provided a cure for the old man's blindness. We find out in the end that Raphael had been an angel all along. And this is okay. We don't expect angels to have a life story like us. The Gospels, however, are a different kind of literature altogether. In them, Jesus has a complete human life. He is conceived, he is born, he is a baby, he grows into a boy, and then a man, and finally he suffers and he dies. If Jesus is not really a human being, but God or an angel, then this entire human biography is not true. The baby in a manger is all a pretense, and everything else in the four Gospels is a pretense too, if God did not really become a human being. There's another aspect to this too. If Jesus is just God pretending to be a man or an angel sent to enlighten us, then no man has ever risen from the dead. And what implications does that have for our own hopes of eternal life? But let's say that Jesus was only a man and not God. The trouble this time is that this contradicts what the Gospels tell us. It means that when Jesus told us he was God, he was either mad or he was lying. And it was a pretty stupid kind of lie because it got him killed. Or else maybe the evangelists who wrote the Gospels were lying. And that doesn't make much sense either, because they got killed too for claiming that he was God. So the best thing to do is to read the Gospels without distraction. They were written by people who knew what they were saying and they wanted to say it. If you think that the Gospels are a work of fiction, then judge them as literature. If you do this, you'll find that each of the four Gospels is a sincere narrative written in mostly not very good Greek by people who aren't really writers, but they don't let that fact stop them from writing, because what they had to say had to be said, and only they could say it. Some critics say that the Gospels are not authentic because sometimes they contradict each other. Contradiction is exactly what you expect when people are really doing their best to report their experiences. If you are reminiscing about the past with family members or with old school friends, you'll know exactly what I mean. We bring the past back to life by telling one another stories about it. When you do this, you are surprised at how quickly people's memories diverge. For example, I may be sure that one thing happened before the other, but you are equally sure that no, the other thing happened before that. So only one of us can be right, but neither of us is lying. The Gospels make it very clear. Jesus Christ was God, and he was also a human being, as fully human as you or I. And I will say more about this in the next talk.
And man will live forevermore because